Hey everybody, so today I decided to talk a little bit about color grading and how it affects your video and certain things that you need to take into account before actually start the process. So without any further ado, let's get into it. Alright, so the first thing I want to talk about is the mood you want your video to convey. If you use very dark blue and green colors, you're going to be showing something a little bit of a dramatic or maybe mysterious or sad way. But if you use like bright colors like red, yellow, whites, you're going to be having a whole different feel on your video, a little bit of this warmth and happy feeling. Hollywood films use this type of color psychology all the time. If they want to show something very dramatic or something very sad, they will go and take blues, greens, and very dark colors. On the other hand, if they want to show happy moments or just this warm feeling, they're going to be using bright colors. So just for the sake of it, I grabbed exactly the same picture and I put these colors very, very bright and these colors in a little bit of a bluish, more dark tone to it. So as you can see, especially like I chose this particular theme because this is food photography, you know, like for food photography, we want to convey something like looking fresh, something a little bit on the bright side, something that looks healthy. So therefore, like I love this type of mood. But you have to think about, is this exactly what I want? Is this what I want? At the end of the day, there is no right or wrong way to do this. It's what you want to show as a creative person. So the second thing I want to talk about are complementary colors. When using right, complementary colors can create something very pleasing for the human eye. And the way we can achieve this type of complementary colors is very simple. Where all we need is a color wheel. So the way complementary color works is, with our color wheel, we're going to take the opposite colors and those colors combined together, they're going to work really well to create a very nice composition. So one of my favorite combination of colors, for example, is blue and golden. And for photography, for video, and for graphic design, it's a very used combination. So just like blue and yellow work really well, there are a lot of combinations that you can play around with in order to create a more pleasing composition. So the last thing I want to talk about is preparation. I'm going to start with video. Before you actually apply an adjustment layer of any type of color grading you want, I strongly advise you to go clip by clip and make sure that every single one of those is perfectly matched with one other. By that I mean contrast, saturation, white balance, all of these things have to be exactly the same or around the same in all of them, because we don't want to have this one very green, this one very yellow, this one too blue, because that's going to hold that to bring the whole thing down. That's going to look very unprofessionally made, and that's not exactly what we want. So my advice to you is go clip by clip and make sure that each one of them and all combined together has exactly the same feel. This is a very tedious work and it's very time consuming, but this extra step is going to have a huge impact on your end result. So after everything is looking the way you want, then you add your color grading, and then this is where you can go nuts. You can change certain things, you can change the saturation, you can change the contrast, you can add some creative things like sharpness, you can change the curves, whatever. But you're going to be doing all your creative process on the adjustment layer, and then on each single clip, you're just going to leave as natural as possible and everything with the same type of look. Now, in photography's case, it's a little bit different because we've got two options. If we just want to do our color grading, let's say for example in Lightroom or Capture One, we are going to take a raw picture, and the whole purpose of this particular pieces of software is to make our color grading. But if we want to take our picture into Photoshop, that's a whole different process, because that means that Camera Raw, Lightroom, or Capture One Pro, or whatever software you're using, the whole point is to, you know, like to make sure our color is as natural as you can without even going nuts. So once we bring everything into Photoshop, we have more real estate to play with, if that makes any sense. The problem though is that if we do all the color grading already, let's say for example in Capture One, if I make all the color all the color grading already in Capture One and I decide to bring the picture later to Photoshop to change something, that means that I can't change what I did here. And then I bring this into Photoshop, I have a lot of things that I can play with. Alright guys, so there you have it. That was a very short video, but in my opinion, these three things are very important before we start our color grading process. And once we figure this, the first two things out, and once we commit to the third thing, I can assure you that your final product is going to look really, really good. I hope you liked it, and I'll see you next week in a whole new video.